Hello again. Today I want to talk about the Blue Greens. The Blue Greens are National's environmental group, and I chair the Blue Greens caucus. I want to talk about the Blue Green agenda and the significant wins that we've had in the environmental space over the last 3 years. Dr. Nick Smith, the Minister of the Environment, and the Blue Greens have worked hard. We've worked hard trying to clean up some of our existing environmental problems and to deliver a more environmentally friendly agenda. And we've had some wins. In 2010, we recorded the cleanest air ever in New Zealand. And that's mainly due to two programs. The first is our clean heat program, which has allowed 26,000 homes to be refitted with clean burning devices. And the other is our Warm Up New Zealand Homes, which is a program that insulates houses, and we've done over 100,000 of them in the last couple of years. That project, in fact both of those projects, have benefits way beyond the environmental. It's good for people's health and welfare, and families across New Zealand are benefiting from it. And we're going to continue those programs in Christchurch as we rebuild those homes there. We've also been cleaning up our waterways and contaminated sites. We've put money into cleaning up the Tui mine, which was such a blot on the Coromandel landscape. And we're spending nearly $100 million cleaning up rivers and lakes across New Zealand. Last week I joined Nick Smith as we signed off a big cleanup for Lake Ellesmere or Lake Te Waihora just out of Christchurch. We'll be working with Naitahu, with Environment Canterbury and with Fonterra, and so with those stakeholders around the table we'll get some real action, and we're looking forward to that. We're liking to see that collaborative model working, and it's working well across the country. One of the best examples is the Land and Water Forum, in which 54 stakeholders have come together to create a framework for managing water quality and water quantity. That's a really important milestone, and I can't thank them enough for their good work. We're making progress in Canterbury too, by pushing forward the community-focused Canterbury Water Management Strategy and by introducing zone committees to deal with water, both quality and quantity, at local grassroots level. Our moderated ETS, Emissions Trading Scheme, is also working well. We're going to meet our Kyoto targets, and that will mean that we'll save $470 million that we would have had to pay otherwise. So it's a practical policy that's delivering. Helen Clark talked a lot about being carbon neutral, but under her watch, emissions increased by 23%. And now, in the last couple of years under National, and without very much fanfare, they've dropped by 4%. That's a real positive. Forestry is also important in keeping that carbon balance, and we've managed to grow about 5.5 million more trees in the last couple of years, whereas under the last 3 years before, under Labor, they chopped down more than 15 million trees. So we're continuing to plant and continuing to grow and continuing to sequester carbon. We're making progress on renewable energy too. In 2010, 74% of the energy used in New Zealand was renewable. That's a record. We're working hard to consent more renewable energy too. And last year we consented 3 times the normal, and it was all renewable. So we're all getting onto that bandwagon and understand exactly how important it is. The same with solar energy. 6,000 homes have accessed a subsidy to turn into solar heating. So you can see, the environment is doing well, it's in good hands of Nick Smith and the Blue Greens, and we've got plenty of new ideas going forward too, including really good measurement of our environment indices so that we really do know what we need to look after, and so that we can all be responsible and accountable for keeping New Zealand clean and green.